Why is a powerful question to answer first. Why defines the purpose? It's an anchor on which all the future decisions are made. People believe when they know why of any transformation initiatives. Why digital transformation is the question any organization need to answer first. With that as context, when we look back, transformation is not new to the business world. Each transformation brought in innovation and new technologies to the business world. Currently, we are in the fourth industrial revolution. When you closely examine each transformation, we can see patterns of characteristics that are common. One, cost shocks. Each transformation brought in innovation in manufacturing from muscle to machine and then automation. Production lead times and cost of productions came down. More and more people have the affordability to buy products and services. Number two, new skills and capabilities are needed to perform the jobs. Transformation introduced new method of performing a task that needed people to learn new skills. However, these disruptions don't happen overnight, like natural calamities or COVID-19. They develop over a period of many years in small bursts and disrupt the industries. With each transformation, companies grew from local markets and expanded to regional, national, and international markets. Industry structure also changed with new suppliers and new business models. Let's take the example of Japanese consumer electronics companies between 70s to 90s. They are very well managed. They are innovative companies and released new products with latest features. They followed the traditional growth cycle, meeting expectations. Their focus was on innovating and improving hardware technologies. After 2000, software technologies were getting better. Japanese companies failed to see these developments. Samsung and Apple understood these shifts. They released new products, combined best of hardware and software technologies. Though they weren't having many advantages initially, over many iterations, they brought great products loved by customers. Japanese companies focused on their products, failed to see changes happening outside of their industry and become obsolete. Let's come back to today's scenarios. We see waves of these digital technologies like cloud, big data, internet of things, automation, 3D printing, robotics, and many more gaining popularity and adoptions. Either as standalone or combination of these technologies have the potential to disrupt the way the business is run today. For a start, any tasks that can be repeated can be automated using digital technologies, and also the companies can completely reimagine the way they are doing the business to new way of doing using digital. Organizations need to build new skill sets and capabilities to better use their employees. Now let's look at what are the impacts of these digital technologies for manufacturing SMEs. SMEs will be able to reach wider customer base through new digital channels and increase the revenue opportunities. Digital technologies can automate production process and improve efficiency, product quality, resulting in cost reduction as well as increase in profitability. Anticipate and engage customers proactively for designing customer-centric products and improve customer satisfactions. And digital technologies can help launch new product or services that are faster, cheaper, and better. If you are not proactively thinking about these priorities, someone else are already thinking or doing it. It's just a matter of time, you can become obsolete. Think broadly about your industry, how it will evolve in the next 2 to 5 years, how this change impact you in short term and long term. This reflection will give you answers specific to why you need digital transformation for your organization and why it need to be on top of your agenda. You can get disrupted or you can be the disruptor. The choice is in our hands. Thank you for watching this video series.